I want to talk to you today about a type of sentence under Canadian criminal law. This is under Section 730 of the Criminal Code, and it's called a conditional discharge. Now, what is a conditional discharge? Well, if a person is found guilty or pleads guilty, one of the sentencing options that applies to many more minor criminal offenses is whether the judge can give them either A, an absolute discharge, or B, a conditional discharge. If the judge finds that it's in the person's best interest and not contrary to the public interest, they can discharge them on conditions. What that means is you've been found guilty, but a conviction is not registered. You don't have a criminal record, in theory at least. You don't have a criminal record. So the judge will impose probation conditions, for example, over and it can be done, you know, for example, for a year, a conditional discharge with probation conditions for a year to keep the peace of being good behavior, not contact an alleged victim, these type of conditions. And as long as you behave yourself during that year, then you don't have a criminal record. There's no problem there, in theory at least. And I want to talk a little bit about this. Now, this is a very good sentencing option for many situations when the Crown offers a conditional discharge. For example, on some domestic assault charges, when there's no injuries, for example, the Crown sometimes will be able to offer you that on extensive submissions with your lawyer. Should you enter into that? Well, that's a loaded question. I mean, if you maintain you're innocent, you might want to have a trial and try and win. On the other hand, if there's risks of losing which are significant and you acknowledge that you did the crime, you should potentially, at least in conjunction with talking to your lawyer, consider at least entering into a conditional discharge if the Crown will offer it. Now, one of the problems I have found and read about online and seen with clients' cases in the past is in our province, there's been really strange disclosure going on by police forces on criminal record checks, on vulnerable sector checks, on what are called police checks. And in some cases, they were disclosing too much information to employers. This was very extensively covered in the Toronto Star, where occasionally some counties were disclosing there was a conditional discharge when they really shouldn't be. There was recent legislation brought in place to try and address this situation. It remains to be seen how that's going to play out. I'm concerned that some counties will still disclose this. So that's one risk, if I might put it that way. But having said that, a conditional discharge is often a good option. You need to talk to your lawyer about it. Go through all your options, whether you should go to trial, whether you should accept the Crown's offer of a conditional discharge, what that means, and how it might affect you in the future. On that note, the law states that on a conditional discharge, the Canadian Police Information Centre should purge that from their system in 3 years. So you can certainly check to see if they've done that, but that's very important. But that's going to be at least in their system for 3 years. So these are some of the considerations for conditional discharges. Absolute discharges is when you're discharged absolutely. There's no conditions, so there's no probation period. These are two considerations you should go through with your lawyer, and it can apply to offenses where there's no mandatory minimum sentence. For example, if you look at sexual assault matters, there's many of these charges have mandatory minimums and a conditional discharge would not be available. For more minor criminal offenses or at least offenses with no mandatory minimums, conditional discharges are available and it's an option that you might want to consider. Thank you for joining me today.